Your call now.
Hey, what's up there?
Hope you are home because I'm close by.
Yeah, you should have. You are free now, you can come around anytime.
Okay. Be seen in just a minute.
Hakim's relatives.
Yes, doctor.
See, I want you to calm down. Put yourself together. Calm down.
Mr. Hakim has been diagnosed of Gaza fever.
Oh, yes.
Doctor, how comes? Two things I got here. It's either he came in contact with an infected person, or he ate food that was contaminated with the excreta of an infected rat.
Yeah.
Lassa fever is an acute viral hemorrhagic illness that is caused by a Lassa virus. It is contacted by coming in contact with food or household items that has been contaminated with the excreta of an infected rat. An infected person too can spread this virus. And it's for this reason that anyone that has had primary or secondary contact with Mr. Kim will have to be quarantined, observed, and tested for this virus.
But doctor, how can we prevent this Lassa fever?
Preventing Lassa fever is not perfect. It's very easy. Lassa fever can be prevented by maintaining a personal hygiene. By this, I mean keeping food or household items very safe.
Why did you check my phone? Why did you check my phone? Don't worry, now is it gone?
Oh boy. You don't go enter secretariat for CDS.
By the way,
why do you they work like that?
Guy, now Gary, I see for one corner, you are just spar. Now I just walk again, energy as the girl they call me and knock out with that package.
Wow, Hakim. I don't want you. Huh. No, say that's a fever now. One kind of bad virus really kill anyhow. But anyway, as you see me so, now CDS I will enter. Sharp, sharp.
Hi.
Same to you. Yeah. You can also be prevented by ensuring that your houses are completely devoid of rats. Finally, you can prevent Lassa fever by reporting cases of anyone with persistent fever, diarrhea, or constant vomiting to the nearest hospital around you. You see, I'm really very sorry here. Accept my heartfelt sympathy.
Thank you, doctor.
Thank you.
Haki!
Yeah, my name is Dr. Ibrahim Adamu. I'm the Acting Director of Public Health and the Chairman of the Rapid Response Task Force for Nasarawa State Ministry of Health for Disease Outbreaks and Epidemics. We create awareness in the general public on what Lassa fever disease is, what the symptoms are, and then what the preventive and control measures are. And also we try to also let the public know that in the event that someone gets Lassa fever, that we have drugs that are available for the treatment and all the other necessary equipment that we need to treat cases. We're also in the business of conscientizing health workers so that they have a high index of suspicion, because traditionally in Nasarawa State we have episodes of Lassa fever outbreaks between December and January, February of every year. So it's something that we want to call it seasonal occurrence. So we want to raise the index of suspicion of health workers so that they know that this is the season, so that they see anybody running temperature 38-39 degrees, then it should be a red flag for them. Yeah, Lassa fever is it's a zoonotic disease.
Okay.
And it's been with us since 1969, when it was first discovered in the Lassa village in the Borno State of Nigeria. And it's been there year in, year out. It's a viral hemorrhagic disease caused by the Lassa fever virus. Now this virus is gotten from rats, mastomys rats, specific kind of rat that has multiple mammary gland. The female has multiple mammary gland.
Okay.
And then they are actually dwellers of the bush. But usually around the season of December, farmers go to burn their bushes, and so they destroy the natural habitats of these rats.
Okay.
And these rats are actually infected from birth, so they have this virus with them as they're giving birth to, but it doesn't cause any disease in the rat.
Okay.
But when these infected rats are displaced from the bushes, they come to the homes.
Okay.
When they come to the homes, they have contact with our food sources.
Okay.
and usually foods that were that are eating uncooked, for instance, and bread, fish, dry fish, gari, you know, things that you don't have to cook. There's no heating involved in preparing those foods, or food that we have cooked and left to eat later.
Okay.
No leftover foods or food that you just cook and keep and then you want to eat later and they're not well protected. So these rats come in there, they eat, they drop their saliva as they eat the food. They pass urine, they pass feces on this food stuff. And those urine, feces and saliva contain the Lassa fever virus.
Wow.
So when an unsuspected person now eats those food, he gets infected with the disease. That's the primary mode of transmission of Lassa fever.
Akachi. Ya za a yi mutum ko mutane ko kuma al'umma gaba ɗaya ko gari su kare kansu daga cutan zazzabin cizon bera. Daga cikin abubuwan da mutum zai kare shine akwai abin da muke kira tsaftacewan kai da kai. Na ce tsaftacewan kai da kai, ke shi wani wancan kowa ya tsaftace jikin shi. In nace tsaftace jikin shi ba kawai kai wanka ba, a'a zaka ci abinci ya zama ka wanke hannu, zaka taba abu, bayan ka taba ko abin da ka san abin nan ka wanke hannunka, wato ya zama tsaftacewa komai zaka yi shi kai shi a cikin tsafta ba a cikin kazanta ba. Daga farkon abin da zaka fara kare kanka kenan. Na biyu shine beraye, tunda mun san beraye ne ke kawo wannan ciwon, kar mu bar gidajenmu da bera. Duk yanda zai kasance ya zama ko ta hanyar magani ko kuma ta hanyar da ya kamata wanda za mu yi kokari beraye ya zama ba su a gidanmu. Na uku, kar mu bar abincinmu a buɗe, ko abincin da ake dafawa wanda idan aka riga aka dafa a bar shi a buɗe ba tare da an rufa kit ba, ko abincin da ba a dafa kamar garin kwaki. Kiyaye barin abinci a buɗe. Na hudu, manoma idan suka girbe kayan nomansu kar su zo su shanya shi a bakin titi, ko da za su shanya ya zama wajen ba wajen da ake tunanin beraye za su zo su yi kashi da fitsari a ciki ba. Saboda muna barin abincinmu ko muna barin kayan nomanmu, beraye za su zo su iya kashi su yi fitsari, wanda idan muka zo za mu iya ci, ko kuma mu sheka ƙoran da ya taso daga garin ɗiban kayan abincin, muna iya shekawa kuma muna iya samun cutar daga wannan hanya. So yana da kyau kayan abincinmu ya zama mun kiyaye, mun keɓe shi, ya zama ba a buɗe ba. So daga cikin alamomin, daga cikin abin da za mu yi mu kare kanmu kenan, ko mu kare al'umma. Daga ciki kuma shine, idan zazzaɓi ya kama mutum, kar mutum ya ce bari in sha paracetamol sai in tafi kawai in kwanta. A'a, sha paracetamol amma ka zo asibiti ka fadawa likita kaza da kaza ne. Likita kila ya fi ka sani me ke faruwa, zai ce maka kaza ne ko ba kaza ne ba. Ko da ma lasan ne, in aka gano ta da wuri, to warkewanta ba wani matsala ba. Amma in aka kai matsalan da sai an samu bulbulowan jini, abin ya yi nisa da yawa, wanda ko an fara ba da magani za a iya warke, amma dai akwai wahala. Aka ce abin da aka gano shi da wuri ai ya fi sauƙin nasara akan abin da bisa kan abin da aka gano shi a cikin ko abin da aka gano shi bayan ya riga an ɓata lokaci. So daga cikin abubuwan da za mu yi mu kare kanmu daga wannan cutan kenan.